Down East Carteret County between Beaufort and Cedar Island is, oddly and uniquely, the land of yeast rolls, except that here they're called light rolls, light bread, or even lightning rolls. No one seems to recall why these rolls became the norm in the maritime communities of Harkers Island, Gloucester, Marshallburg, Davis, Stacy, Sea Level, and Atlantic.
We down Easters, we're called, always had yeast rolls. East of the North River Bridge on US 70, the beginning of the original Down East. But west, Moorhead and a lot of Beaufort had regular clabber biscuits, and they were good too.
Earl Fulcher of Davis, who lives right on Core Sound, has won baking contests with his light rolls. He agreed to demonstrate, and we'll tell you where to find the exact recipe.
I use a 9-cup recipe. I have put 6 in here, and I've got almost 3 more ready to put. Then I add a little more later on if I need it.
Yeah, so you'll do,
so you can put that, put, yeah,
put that in
that's
there.
It.
Okay, there we go.
So that's our flour to start out with right there.
Earl adds 2 tablespoons of salt to the flour, which is bread flour in his version. Then he mixes 2 tablespoons of yeast, 2/3 of a cup of sugar, and enough water to fill a 1-quart jar. After pouring enough into the flour to make room, he then adds a cup of oil to the remaining liquid. He recommends half-melted lard and half canola oil.
And pour the whole contents in the flour. Now we're going to stir this up. Mix it.
Earl says the dough should be really wet at this stage, so all the ingredients become well incorporated into the flour.
So you're going to add just a little bit, just judging as what you think it needs.
That's right. I grew up with it, and then those that made it passed on, and there wasn't anybody left to make it. So I said, all right, I will.
So really, that's why you decided to do it, because really you were the last option?
Yeah, well, my sister showed me how to do it. She knew from family orientation hand-me-downs.
But was that because you were interested, or because wanted to have a steady supply of light rolls?
I wanted a supply. The rest of the procedure is by hand. You can see the dough beginning to take shape. And as long, the wetter, more moist you can have it, the better bread you get.
So it gets more elastic and wetter, I guess, the more you do
see,
that?
See, that's right. And keep adding a little flour as you need it. Put some on your hands. And this is what the old people call working it.
Working the dough.
Kneading is the proper term, I guess.
But you all say working the dough.
We say we were working it.
Earl regularly adds a little of the flour he reserved whenever his hands begin to feel sticky until he's satisfied with its elasticity, then divides it into 2 halves, each enough for 1 pan of rolls. He puts it in the refrigerator for a day to ferment a little, although everyone doesn't do this. The next day, he forms his rolls from the chilled dough, waits for them to rise only once until about double in size, then bakes them. This eliminates one whole earlier step of letting the dough rise and punching it back down that many bakers use.
Earl, you made the rolls, you roll the dough. About all I'm good for here is to butter one. Cheers.
Cheers.
Here we go. All right.
We took along some yeast rolls to a weekly senior lunch at the United Methodist Church in Atlantic, and we got lots of reminiscences.
That's good. Good light rolls.
Well, you have to know that you're going to be home most of the day, because you've got to watch the dough and see when it's just right after you've worked it up. And then you have to put it back and let it rise some more, and then you have to watch that and see when it's just right. So it has to be on a day when you're not going anywhere.
Downeasters love to eat light rolls with preserved figs, which are also abundant in the area.
My mother and my granny before her, we lived with her for a while, made light rolls all the time. My mother, whenever she made light rolls, she'd make 5 pounds of flour at a time. That's the only way she ever made it. And then it was good for several days. And we had fig trees, so we preserved figs.
Donald Willis remembers a fishing trawler captain he once worked for taking his wife's refrigerated light roll dough on offshore trips, letting the rolls rise in the warm engine room.
And we ate light rolls three times a day, and we carried one loaf, or we called it baker's bread, it's loaf bread from the marina. And when all else failed, when that light roll ran out, we came home. Regardless, we came home, and that loaf of bread was an emergency ration.
Whether with cheese or even pork cracklings folded into the dough, or whether they're consumed plain with lots of butter and or preserves, Down East light rolls have been an eastern Carteret County mainstay at least since the late 1800s, even before commercial yeast was available, and when leavening was derived from a starter culture. Along with the abundant seafood, they are unquestionably the region's staff of life.